Welcome to the Spotlight. I'm Britt.
And I'm Tyler.
How's it going tonight, Tyler?
It's going real good.
Yeah? How are you feeling?
I'm feeling better. I was sick last week.
Poor Tyler.
I stuck in there and did the show anyway.
That's good.
What do you got there?
Guess what? Okay. My roommate's mommy brought us Easter baskets. And so I decided I was going to bring them on the show and show them off. I got these bubbles and I got some silly putty, which is we're going to talk about the silly putty a little later. I also got this nice little candy necklace. I'm kind of waiting for somebody to eat it off. It's going to be exciting and probably is going to make my day.
And if you want to eat it off, call 224. That was a
no.
joke.
That
was
See, a watch joke. This.
Neat.
This is a fully functional Easter present and it's amazing. All right, so what are we doing tonight, Tyler? I don't even know.
Well, we got Jake Miller from the Honor Society, and he's the president of Scientia. And he's gonna come out and talk to us about what they do with the Honor Society and what they do with Scientia. So why don't you come on out, Jake? How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Tyler?
Yeah.
Britt?
Hello.
Hi.
I have bubbles all over my hands, so sorry.
It's okay.
They were a little wet. So tell us, you're Jake?
Yep.
Where are you from?
From Pierre, South Dakota.
From Pierre?
Yep, I'm a junior here at Black Hills State.
Awesome. Your major?
Biology and chemistry.
Ooh.
Hoping to someday go to med school if I can ever get out of this place.
Okay, that's good.
Sound like you want to get out there pretty quick, huh?
No, I've still got another 2 years, so.
Yeah. I think that's about what I'm going to be sitting at, too, so.
Seems like everybody's on the 5-year plan.
Yeah.
It's a good plan.
Yeah, it is a good plan. I'm on the 4.5-year plan,
huh.
So at least I'm making out a little early.
Yeah.
All right, so you're in 3 different groups on campus. Which ones are they and what do they do?
Oh, well, I'm in Scientia, which is just a science program for anybody in the science majors. I mean, you can be in psychology, biology, chemistry. Doesn't really matter as long as you have somewhat of an interest in science.
Okay.
What we do is, we actually haven't done a whole lot this semester, but what we've done in the past is we've run the Quiz Bowl. And what we do there is we pull around 40 high schools, and that's sophomores, juniors, and seniors, and we run it just like a quiz show. And quiz them on science topics, whether it's chemistry, biology. And then they do double elimination until they have a champion. So it's kind of fun. And then I'm in HSSO, which is Health Science Student Organization. And it's for pre-professional students, pre-med, pre-optometry, pre-PT, anybody who's going into sort of the clinical medical situation.
Okay.
And what we've done in HSSO this year is we like to bring in people who are in the medical field. Whether that's, we just brought in a lady last week from the medical technician from Rapid. And she got to talk to us about what they do, how you get in their program, and stuff like that.
All right.
And so you get to learn a lot about these programs. And then, I guess I'm also the president of Scientia, but then the other program is the honors program, and below that is the honors organization.
Okay.
And so members from the honors program are actually in the club.
Okay.
And we run the blood drives on campus, and we actually do the Young Jacket Spelling Bee, or Little Jacket Spelling Bee, something like that.
Well, it sounds like you got a pretty busy schedule.
Yeah,
nice of you to come down and
trying to keep up.
Meet with us on the Spotlight.
Yeah, for sure.
You mentioned the spelling bee that you run.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, tonight we're gonna take Richard and Josh, and we're gonna have them heads up with the help of Jake Miller on a spelling bee to see who can do the better spelling between the two of them.
It's going to be pretty intense.
Yeah.
From what I hear.
Yeah. Let's go ahead and take a look at that.
Hey, I'm Richard.
I'm Josh.
And I'm Jake, and welcome to the first annual KBHU-TV Spelling Bee. First, Richard.
Yes.
Spell cheese.
You kidding me? Like cheese? Like you put on a sandwich?
Spell cheese.
Okay. Let me think. C H double E S E in your face.
That is correct. Josh, spell Kapawi.
Ooh, Kapawi. Can I have the country of origin?
Uzbekistan.
Uzbekistani, huh? Kapawi. K A P O W Y.
That is correct. Sure. Spell rock.
Rock. Can you use it in a sentence?
Don't step on the rock.
Okay. Don't step on the rock. R O C K.
That's correct.
Rock.
Josh.
Yes.
Spell bidet.
Could you use it in a sentence?
A bathroom fixture used especially for bathing the external genitals and anal region.
Could I have a country of origin?
Tanzania.
Tanzania. Bidet. B. E. D. E. T.
That is incorrect. The score is 2-1. Richard. Spell overbite.
Overbite. O V E R B I T E.
That is correct. Josh.
Yeah.
Spell ginormous.
Could you use it in a sentence?
A combination of gigantic and enormous, something that is very big, something that is large or massive. Mount Everest is a ginormous mountain.
Ginormous. G Y N A. That's it.
That is incorrect. The score is 3-1. Richard.
Yes.
Spell apple.
Apple. Can you use that in a sentence?
Don't eat the rotten apple.
Ooh, okay. Apple. A double P L E.
That
is
correct.
Can I say double P? Is that safe in the world of spelling bees?
Yes.
Okay, it's acceptable.
And the last word on our list. If you get this wrong, you lose. And Richard will win.
I lose my chest hair.
Yes.
And your dignity.
I've already lost that.
Spell tautomerization.
T E S T I C L E S.
That is incorrect. Richard is the
yes.
winner. You
lose.
Suck. And that was the first annual Collegiate KBHU Spelling Bee.
That's right. I'm your winner. Britt, Tyler, take it away.
Okay. All right. That was pretty competitive there. That was a lot of fun. Thanks for doing that, Jake.
No problem.
I like the way you set that up and stuff. And
yeah, I mean, thanks for coming down here in the first place. That was
yeah.
very kind of you. You seem to be a busy dude, so.
And now we get to make good on the bet, of course.
Of course,
the
bet.
The bet made at the beginning of the deal was that if...
whoever loses gets to wax their chest.
And sorry, Josh, but we're going to go ahead and rip all your hair off your chest, so.
Mm-hmm. And here's the disclaimer, Robin Hazlett, who was nice enough to come in and join us for this excursion, and I, we did not read the directions. So for all of you professional hair waxers out there, yes, we realized we were doing this wrong.
That's why it probably hurt him so much.
Probably. We're also testing the pain threshold of a 24-year-old male for Jake, because he would like to know, in case he ever turns 24 and would like to get his chest waxed.
I'm Josh Wolf. I'm in Tyler Hoffman's kitchen. We're about to wax my chest. I'm an idiot. And the wax is fresh peach melon. And let me see that wax. Could you keep it in your hands? There's the wax. And by the way, it tastes like mangoes. And it does. I'm freaking serious. So, here we go. This is Robin Hazlett. Apparently she knows how to do this. Maybe a little bit more than Brit. I don't know, either way, this is a terror. But Robin, thank you for joining us today to help us out.
Anytime.
This is for the homies. I hope this works.
Good
job.
Say goodbye.
What about this?
Work on it. No, see, I think.
I'll just spread it thinner like that.
You just go like this. The problem here is that Josh has a little bit of angry to have hair.
I'm a German.
You'll be fine.
She says. This is not cool, this is not cool, this is not cool. Ow!
Hey! Progress! We got some!
Puts a lotion on the skin or it gets its own. What? Oh, Gandhi. Oh, Gandhi. Ow! Oh! you win, but a battle in the war. I just choked on my own spit. Kids, don't try this at home. Oh, devil. Ah! Oh! Stop! Ah! Boobs! Oh! Oh! Ow! Oh! Jesus, it didn't come off. That kind of works.
Good stuff.
Ouch.
Ouch is
great. Was he bleeding?
I think there's a little bit of blood. Oh, that was my kitchen floor too, by the way. I don't think I'm ever going to eat in my kitchen again, so.
It's all right. All right, well, thanks, Jake, for coming down here.
Yeah,
today.
Thanks a lot to Jake, and thanks to Robin Hazlett for coming down and helping out with the chest waxing, and we will see you guys next week.
Thanks for stopping in. All right, so tell me a little bit about this silly
buddy. I don't understand the person asking.